everybody. I'm Maggie Steffens, two-time Olympic gold medalist and captain for the USA women's water polo team. In 2012, I was named the MVP of the Olympic Games and scored a record amount of goals for a woman in one single Olympics. A critical part of the game of water polo is your outside shot. Today, we're gonna focus on how to increase the power and accuracy of that outside shot. Now, a lot of people think it's about the arm and how strong it is, but really, that's all a trick. Number one, it's about your legs and your stability. And number two, it's about your shoulder and your wrist. This is how we can develop a powerful and accurate shot. So I'm gonna show you some drills and skills that I did growing up and I still do today that helped me have a powerful and accurate shot. And these are all things that you can do to develop your water polo game outside of the water. So let's see what we can do as we try to develop our power and our accuracy in our shot. All right, so for this drill, we're gonna focus on developing that wrist. The best position you can be is getting in that 90 degree with that wrist, almost like you're holding a pizza box. You wanna hold it as flat as possible, loose in the hand, and then when you finish, finishing with that flick of the wrist, as we call it on our team. So what's really important about this outside shot is the way you finish. You wanna have your body in a good position, stable, and when you finish, you actually wanna use your wrist at the end to point at where you want the ball to go. It's as simple as that. Wherever your pointer finger points, that is where the ball will go. So for this drill, all you need is a band and something to hook it to. It doesn't matter where you are. It could be to a tree. I'm using a post outside the house. And this is to isolate our wrist. So a lot of people only bring it back a little bit and then don't finish. So now you've lost your power. You've lost that quickness. So I want you to think of your wrist, the way it goes back, almost like you're launching a water balloon. The farther you bring it back, the farther and more powerful it will propel itself forward. So I'm imagining the goal is in front of me. Isolate that wrist, flick, point. You should feel it. My wrist is already burning. A trick here is your core is activated. Common mistake is leaning on your side or leaning on your back instead of focusing on that core stability you have. So when you're doing these exercises, make sure you're upright and not leaning on your side or leaning on your back. All right, so if you're up for a challenge, put a physio ball underneath you so that you can activate that core. This adds that element that happens in a water polo game. So at the advanced level, throw this in there. Give yourself a challenge. Still practice that wrist, all the qualities you need. And if you're at this level, you can probably mix your wrist up to different locations. This will help you develop that power and accuracy you need in that shot. So another drill for this, now that you've warmed up your wrist with the band, is incorporating the ball. And really all you need is a small surface. So I'm gonna do that same flick of the wrist movement, and I'm using a wall so that I can practice that back and forth. So I want your hand to be soft as you absorb the ball. If you try to absorb the ball hard, it's gonna ricochet off. Absorb the ball light and flick it forward. As you get better, you can start to back up. This is gonna get tiring, but it's something you can do all the time. Remember these tips to help up your game. Pizza box, make sure you bend your wrist back 90 degrees or even further. Isolate the wrist and flick for speed. Point in the direction you want the ball to go. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you guys try out these tips and tricks at home and let us know how it goes in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to try out all these tips for yourself and let them know, sorry. My hair is getting bigger, I swear, by the second.